Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étrange retentisse par ici. Moi, te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche. C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur. Dans mon temps, c'était comme sur l'image. On était vrais, fiers, forts, puis on avait le bon lieu de notre bord. Vois-tu le livre, là? C'est le Wendigo. Ouais, le Wendigo. Un guerrier qui devient un loup pour se venger de sa grosse peine. Et la Corriveau, bâtesse, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau. Elle tuait tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage. Oyez, 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 il y a un petit gars d'écarté dans ma maison. Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. Ben oui, une couche. Tu peux-tu tout faire en même temps, toi? Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. La Corriveau, bâtesse, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau. Elle tuait tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage. C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur. Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles. C'est vrai, le jeune, que tu te promènes quasiment en bobette. Une bonne pelisse, ça te ferait pas de tort. Mais je vais te dire une chose, dans ton coin de pays comme Paris-ci, on n'a rien sans rien.
Et où, mon caribou?
Et la Corriveau, ta tête. Ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau. Elle tuait tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage. D'apparence que mon caribou tarde. There, Carl had fed his mind, but had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter. And its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out. Was becoming increasingly convinced that this was not normal hunting. The game that was being tracked was fearsome, so much so that the hunter didn't dare approach it. What could it be? The air was freezing, right down to the bone.
Yeah. that window had seemingly been left open for a while, Carl thought. Given the punishing weather, it couldn't have been intentional. Carl felt a cool, tingling sensation in his back. Another vision took over him. Something was hidden under the stairs. The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him. Perhaps their spousal relationship had been cooling down lately. It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house. The vision's veil was lifted, and he was back to reality. A reality in which Giselle, Jill's loving spouse, was motionless, frozen in ice. Carl had seen that kind of safe before, with its double-layered security system blending letters and numbers. Its code couldn't be broken by the common burglar. The general store, along with several more infrastructures in the area, had been acquired by wealthy industrialist William J. Hamilton. Perhaps the village should be rechristened Hamiltown. Beautiful portrait of Jill and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the LaChausses had just moved in. What a mess! Clearly, there was some major revamping work underway here. The place looked barely habitable. Looks like the holes in that puzzle are there to stay. The pot was cold, and the stew inside wasn't cooked. It's likely that poor Giselle was slow cooking it before she got snapped. What a waste. What could be inside that envelope? Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service. Carl had no idea how to interpret a message like that. On the surface, it seemed like he had one half too many. Many of this puzzle. Enough to know he shouldn't take this testimony as gospel. The entire thing, being some punishment for a murder committed by Hamilton, seemed like an outlandish theory. Carl was doubtful. Thank you. That window had seemingly been left open for a while, Carl thought. Given the punishing weather, it couldn't have been intentional.
Thank you.